Yeah, it's Sri Lanka Design Festival, which is an event I founded in 2009, but really under a new banner, I mean, called Innovation Island. So Innovation Island means Sri Lanka wants to be an inspiration source in terms of now not only taking what the region has to offer, but you know, what our neighbors in South Asia has to offer. So kind of be a catalyst for India, Bangladesh, Pakistan, you know. We can't do it in isolation. We need to connect with the rest of the world. And I saw two partners clearly. In terms of policy making, I saw one particular country. But in terms of the innovation side and design, we really feel the Dutch have something really special to offer. And we've been following, you know, what's happening over there. I really feel they're the right partners, the Dutch design culture is the right partner for us to take the future journey with. I think it's the future of what the Dutch are doing is really, I mean, really groundbreaking. And I think Sri Lanka and our part of the world need to see some of that as well. You know, the Dutch have always been part of our heritage, but how can they be part of our future journey in innovation and modern design and all of that?
We tried to set up a program that was as broad as possible. So we did it in cooperation with AOD. The role of design is not anymore limited to a specific product or a specific service, but that you have to take into account the whole environment, you could say, and that it's about system development with all kinds of stakeholders, and that you have to design, you could say, the ways of working to bring the stakeholders all at the table and come up with new solutions.
We have interesting table discussions with the Sri Lankans, and the challenge for us as Dutch people is not only to send to them the way we have realized the status of cultural and creative industries from nowadays, but also to zoom in into their unique situation. And what I'm really inspired from is that the Academy of Design here in Sri Lanka has taken the lead actually in developing their cultural and creative sectors, which I find very good, very interesting, and they also manage actually to gather a lot of design and other creative companies here over the past 2 days.
As you might know, the Netherlands is well known as the innovation leader. It's the second most innovative economy in the world according to the Global Innovation Index. It really gives me great pleasure to be here today and to see so many people here gathering together for this round table. A lot of Dutch expertise being present with a very diverse background. And really it's about building a design-driven ecosystem and turning Sri Lanka into a design hub.
So what I've noticed by being here in Sri Lanka is that there's a lot of expertise being cultivated on crafts and textile design and graphic design. And what I hope to bring here in Sri Lanka is the notion of strategic design and service design. So how can we use this designerly way of working, of moving towards disrupting the ways of working of industries, of sectors, to really see how we can make a difference in the system itself?
The Sri Lankan perspective, what I think is one, that design is a lot bigger than designing a product, a single thing that you can hold, but that design is a mindset, it's a way of working, that can be applied to many different things. By doing that, it can be applied to services, it can be applied to organizations, and really have an impact in how people work. And I think that Sri Lanka might actually have an opportunity to frog leap what we did in Europe. That would be marvelous if they can skip that whole part of wasteful behavior that we've gone through in the West.
It was actually quite interesting. This is actually one of the first forums I've been to that's been organized by AOD, and the speakers here were from the Netherlands. So like how their kind of implementations could be used and implemented in Sri Lanka, and like there's such a big inspiration and a new way of thinking about how we can improve all our designs, our companies and things like that.
Or with other artists, and we're not really like having maybe TV shows that show how design can impact people's lines at home, or how artisans, everybody can be an artist, everybody can be a designer, and how brands have started from hobbies.
So what we're doing is finding out what the strengths and the weaknesses are of the Sri Lankan design sector, the design economy, and comparing that to the Dutch and the European way of working, and then see what the strengths are that you can build from and what the weaknesses are that you want to make stronger.
So if we were to have some case studies that showed the impact of design and set that out as a campaign, and then also that would be seen on like grassroots level as well, so seeing what it can do for the people. And we were having a discussion about that's really only going to get recognized through economic impact.
All the action plans that are in place in several in the Netherlands, but also in several European countries, to see if they could be useful in setting up a plan for Sri Lanka too. Of course, we will give this results back as is, so they will have an overview of strengths and weaknesses, but it gives us the possibility to go back to the Netherlands and see if we can find possible organizations, universities, schools that might want to help them with it and become a collaboration partner, which was the second goal of our project.
So I think the first step is really bringing in, curating this correct kind of stakeholders to come and interact with us. So I think that's been a really big success in my opinion. I think they've really picked the correct people to come here. So that's a good starting point. I mean, like, if we have, at the end of the 5 years, if we really have been this inspirational source from the region, we've taken what Bangladesh has to offer, or what India has to offer, or what Bhutan has to offer. It could be from product, to it could be a way of thinking that India had, you know, that they've shared with the rest of the world. It could be any of those. And the success would be in 5 years' time if we are that catalyst.